big recent news yesterday was the firing of Urban Meyer. And there's been a lot of talk about what type of coaching works in the NFL and what type of coaching works in college. But bullying has been a word used often here. So there's comparisons to Belichick, but Belichick has had so much success in the NFL. So why do you think that his coaching style has worked? You know, he also has a rookie quarterback, but, you know, why is it working for Belichick?
You know, I think the way Bill Belichick has operated, you know, from the beginning, having that early success can really give you credibility, I think, mm-hmm. in the NFL. And he has been a guy that, I mean, you could go back and trace his coaching career back decades before he got to the Patriots, how successful he was as a defensive coordinator. That gets you a start with the credibility. But when your program and how tough you are as a coach, creates results on the field the way it did in 2001 for the Patriots, all of a sudden you get guys buying into that program a lot easier. I mean, these are professionals. These are adults. They're not college kids. They're not 18, 19, 20-year-olds. So to get them to buy in, they need to see the results. And I think with Belichick, he's obviously a really smart and, you know, really just, you know, he's the best coach of all time.
Right.
But because he had that early success, I think that was important. Any coach that's coming in first time in the NFL, and certainly that's what went wrong with Urban Meyer, is, you know, you start to get some bad results early, and then you have some of the off-the-field distractions that he did, and you treat people, you know, the way he reportedly treated their kicker there, and that's, you know, that stuff's not going to fly. So I think Belichick is certainly the model that a lot of people are trying to follow, and a lot of his own assistants haven't even been able to follow the model that he created, because the way he game plans, the way he prepares, it bleeds right through. And it's just such a professional building from top to bottom. You know, these guys understand that it's not an easy place to play, but they also get the rewards for that on Sundays. And that matters. That resonates with players. And I think it's what's made Bill Belichick successful, even as he gets to this point where, you know, he's bringing in all these new players that haven't played for him before, mm-hmm. but they look around and they see, you know, Matthew Judon's a great example, a guy that, you know, came up with the Ravens, comes to the Patriots. He sees the results. Why wouldn't he buy in? He's got a career high in sacks already. He knows that, you know, the little things that Belichick points out, you know, in throughout the course of the week are going to help him out on Sundays. So when you have that kind of reputation, it becomes a lot easier to get players to buy in. And I think that's why, I mean, he must be having fun, because here he is, you know, going on 70, and he's, you know, got a rookie quarterback, and he seems to have as much energy for the job as he ever has.
Mm-hmm. I mean, life is so much easier when you're winning. It's a lot harder when you're losing, but we see the relationship that him and Brady had, and they did play each other earlier this season and had a moment and everything. So there's definitely mutual respect, but obviously Brady wanted to go elsewhere. So would you call Belichick a bully, or is he maintaining the respect from his players?
No, I think he maintains the respect of his players. There's a good mm-hmm. give and take there. Earlier this year, we did a story at The Athletic of, you know, some players' funniest Belichick stories. And one thing a lot of players mentioned was, you know, he would crack jokes and rag on guys a little bit, but there were guys in that locker room that could give it back, and Belichick could take it. He even mentioned the other day, one of the things he loves about having Brandon Bolden, a veteran, in the locker room is that he's not afraid to, you know, goof on Belichick when he does something wrong and lighten the mood in that way. So yeah, I mean, Belichick can be a hard guy to play for. He can, you know, be really hard on his players, but I do think there's a good give and take there. And that's the type of thing that can get guys to respect you. In addition to winning and everything mm-hmm. else, there's a consistency that guys like. They know what they're getting with Bill Belichick all the time. And I think they like that he can, you know, make a joke at his own expense and take a joke at his own expense when the situation calls for it. He has a really good understanding of the psychology of his team and, you know, a good feel for moments and how to press the right buttons. And that's critical to being a coach and to lasting as long as he has and having the success that he's had is understanding that component of building a team, because it changes every year with every new group of players that you have. You need to take a slightly different approach and see how the team comes together. So I think he's definitely a guy that has a lot of respect from, you know, just about everybody who's played for him. You call up so many guys and they just rave about what he did for their career.